Joey Mathers is best known for playing Theodore Beaver Cleaver in the hit TV sitcom Leave It to Beaver. He takes a trip down memory lane with our very own Craig Bennett to discuss his friendship with Alfred Hitchcock and co-star Tony Dow. Plus, he reveals the moment that changed his life forever.
Joey Mathers has been a Hollywood star since he was a tot, but it was in 1957 that the busy young actor beat out over 1,700 other boys to land the role of Theodore Beaver Cleaver on the now iconic TV sitcom Leave It to Beaver.
Well, Joey Mathers, how is this for a wow? You are in the record books as, well, essentially the last surviving major star of the longest continuously running to air TV show in history.
It's true, but it's, for me, kind of sad because I remember all the people that I worked with that were all very, very good friends of mine. And I, being so young at the time, I had a great time, but a lot of them are not around anymore.
But your memories are there and they're very warm to your heart, Jerry. You think about it, since 1957, Leave It to Beaver has not been off the air, and in over, like, I think it's 127 countries, in 91 languages all over the world. So that's what now, 65 years.
It's a show that, you know, it's just about a boy growing up in America a few years ago. And so a lot of people have liked it and they think it's a good show, and it is.
Jerry was already a showbiz veteran by the time Leave It to Beaver came along. You see, he was 2 years old when he was first discovered in a Los Angeles department store, but it wasn't long before Hollywood came a-calling.
Mom happened to be walking through a department store, and she was looking for clothes for me, and a lady came up to her and said, "Is this your little boy?" And my mom said, "Oh, whatever he touched and broke, I'll pay for it," you know. And the lady said, "No, but we've noticed you've been trying his clothes on, and they fit him perfectly, and we do a modeling show. And all he'd have to do would be come in, and a model would take his hand, and he would go up on stage and do a couple turns and stuff." And my mom kind of said, "Well, I don't know." And the lady said, "Well, if you did that, whatever outfit he was wearing, he could keep." My mom said, "He could do that."
Jerry's movie career kicked off shortly after, and he starred alongside Bob Hope in The Seven Little Foys.
"This your son, Eddie?"
"No, he's not my father."
And Linda Darnell in This Is My Love.
"Why don't we give her some medicine instead, huh?"
"It's gotta be cut out. They said if Daddy had blood, it's gonna have to die."
You were in a wonderful Hitchcock movie called The Trouble with Harry, where you played Shirley MacLaine's son.
"Harry, thank Providence, the last of Harry."
If in your career that's not a pinch yourself moment, Jerry, I'm not quite sure what is.
The funny part is that was one of her very first movies. She was just an up-and-coming star at the time. She was a really nice lady. I got to see her a little bit more when she was doing a lot of the shows at Universal Studios when I was doing Leave It to Beaver.
"Hey, what's he doing in our bathtub?"
Because it's funny, you hear a lot of people critical of Alfred Hitchcock. I mean, his brilliance as a filmmaker is without question. But you see a lot of people commenting on what he was like to work with, that he was either a bit creepy or a bit strange. I know Bill Mooney, who worked with him in Alfred Hitchcock Presents, found him very intimidating. You found him a total delight, didn't you?
Well, we were back in Stowe, Vermont. And so it was just the camera crews. And, you know, he'd call me over and I'd sit on his lap. He'd read the line to me and I'd do it. And he said, "I want this line to be a little bit sharper," or whatever. He was just a really nice guy.
But it was Leave It to Beaver that turned a 9-year-old Jerry into a world-famous TV sensation.
That interview, they were looking for everybody. They wanted the Beaver, they wanted Wally, they wanted Eddie, they wanted Lumpy.
"Hi, Lumpy. Hey, Wally, what's up?"
Why do you think it is, Jerry, that Leave It to Beaver is up there with the likes of the Mary Tyler Moore Show, the Dick Van Dyke Show, I Love Lucy, as absolute TV icons?
It was a show that in the 50s, people would want to watch, and they'd sit there with their kids and say, "You see that what happened to Beaver? You see what he did? Did you see what happened? Don't you ever do that?" And they'd say, "Yeah, I never do that."
"I fill the bathtub so I'd be ready for our alligator."
"Beaver, if we keep him in there, we won't be able to take a bath."
"Yeah.
What do you do that for?"
"I don't know, but you're supposed to."
You know, you often read about co-star rivalries, but on Leave It to Beaver, it was a very happy set. And you and Tony Dow, playing brothers, as I understand it, got on absolutely famously.
Why didn't you give it to Mom?
I'm scared of what's in it.
But you don't know what's in it.
That's what I'm scared.
He was about 4 years older than me, but he was a little intimidating because he was an AAU swimming and diving champion. Mm-hmm. And he could do things like take 4 or 5 steps, jump up in the air, do a front flip and land on his feet. And I'm thinking, I can't do that. And I wasn't around a whole lot of other kids. And I'm thinking, I wonder if everybody else can do that, but I can't.
Tony Dow, who became a heartthrob as the blonde-haired, blue-eyed Wally, Jerry's TV brother, died last year of liver cancer. And his death left Jerry reeling.
He was always this person that could do anything. And I just was, shocked. But there's nothing you can do about it.
Wally, why are you putting that goop on your hair?
It's not goop. It's Groomwell.
He was just a great friend, a wonderful person.
Beaver!
Barbara Billingsley, such a classy, classy lady. But Hell's Bells was her way of expressing her frustration, wasn't it? And then think, whoops, I shouldn't have said that.
She didn't say it too much, but yeah, whenever she'd make a mistake, she would at least mutter it. And you know, when you're working like that, especially working with kids, we might have given her the wrong line or something or whatever, and she would lose track and suddenly say something, and she'd go, oh, Hell's Bells.
For those who missed the very last episode of Leave It to Beaver, all was revealed as to how Theodore was given the nickname of Beaver.
I had asked the writers and producers, Joe Conley and Bob Mosier, about it, and they said, well, they were looking for kind of a fun name, and they just happened to fall upon that. They'd tried some others. They'd bring their secretaries in, because they all had like 3 or 4 secretaries, and they'd tell them, what about this one? What about this one? And the one that all the secretary liked was the Beaver.
Leave It to Beaver was such a hit, it returned in the 80s as a TV movie titled Still the Beaver. Then there was the sequel TV series, The New Leave It to Beaver.
I got to go into the Hugh Beaumont position of being a father and having kids of my own.
Dad, I think we just saved you a lot of money.
You're right. Your allowance is gone for the next 2 weeks.
And in the 90s, there was a big screen Leave It to Beaver movie which featured some of the original stars, but not Jerry.
I'm worried about the Beaver.
Where were you?
I was doing another movie at the time, and so they, you know, already were in production, so it's not like they could just stop everything. And it wasn't even in the Los Angeles area. I was very sad I couldn't do it, but I couldn't tell these people that I was working for that were paying me, oh no, I'm gonna go do something else back in California.
Happiness is RBN.
After 6 seasons and 234 episodes, the original Leave It to Beaver wrapped in 1963. Jerry then graduated from college, got a job in a bank, became a real estate developer.
Styles keep a-changing, the world's rearranging. Edna, you're timeless to me.
Then he re-entered showbiz and, in 2007, starred on Broadway in Hairspray.
Time cannot take what comes free.
Along the way, Jerry's life has had its ups and downs. In the 90s, he suffered a big health scare.
I was at the time working as an actor, but I also had a catering company. But I might eat 3 or 4 meals a day, and it was very, very good food. So I thought, oh, dang, this is the good life. All of a sudden, I looked, and I was really very, very much overweight. And my doctor, when I went in for a yearly physical, said, if you don't do something, you're going to be dead pretty soon.
And you essentially from there became the spokesperson for diabetes issues all over the world, didn't you? Because you were very public about your situation.
I wouldn't have been able to do that kind of thing if I didn't really think that the American Diabetes Association, you know, and I found out what I'd been doing to myself. I mean, I thought, oh, you know, everybody eats a little bit. Everybody's a little bit overweight. But I found out that when people that have diabetes go overweight, there's a lot more consequences than your normal person that just, you know, takes it by accident.
And not only that, but as they say in the classics, Jerry, the third time is a charm. And it was 12 years ago you married your beautiful wife, Teresa.
Absolutely. Come over here, Teresa.
Come on, Teresa.
Hello.
Hello.
You two can give one another a great big kiss now. Why don't you? Oh, that's it. True love. See, I told you, Jerry, I could tell it was in my waters. Third time is absolutely definitely the charm and the keeper.
Yes, he practiced twice. So, you know, that's fine.
Well, practice makes perfect, doesn't it? And that's how it came about.
It really does.
Yes, it does.